Hi, I'm Lindsay Baumgren, and today I'm gonna lead you through a full body stretching routine. A great way to cool down after any workout or stretch it out when you're tired and sore. Okay, so we're no warm up, no cool down, this is it. We are just stretching and it's gonna feel so good. So just find yourself right here, feet underneath your hips. Give me a big inhale, reach up nice and tall. Exhale, baby back bend, just drop down, pull elbows down towards your hips, opening up through the chest and shoulders, nice. Reach up tall again. You're gonna drop your right arm. Give me an open arm twist. So gaze follows my fingertips. Take that right hand to the small of the back. Lift the left arm up and over. Nice little back stretch. Open up through that front body. Nice. Reach it back up nice and tall. Same thing, other side. Drop the left arm. Open arm twist. Gaze follows my left fingertips. Left hand goes to the small of my back. Right hand goes overhead. Just opening up. Feel that nice shoulder stretch right here in that left arm. Nice, reach up nice and tall. Take a big inhale, and on the exhale, give me a nice forward fold. That feels so, so good. Just let it all hang heavy. Everything melts down towards the ground. Release the tongue from the roof of the mouth. Nice, hold here. From here, you're gonna plant your right hand to the ground. Left arm is gonna go up. Gaze is gonna follow the fingertips. I'm gonna take a nice soft bend in that right standing leg. Just opening up. If you want, you can reach for a half wrap, reaching for the opposite hip right here. Nice half wrap. This feels so good. Hold here for 3, 2, and 1. Switch it out. Other side. Left hand to the ground. Right arm goes up to the sky. Gaze follows the fingertips. Nice soft bend in that standing left leg. Option to stay here or take that half wrap, reaching for the opposite hip. Nice. Hold here for 3, 2, and 1. Take it down. Everything hangs heavy. You're actually going to grab opposite elbows or biceps, finding ragdoll pose. Just let it all sway heavy side to side. Should feel really good. When you're ready, plant your hands. You're gonna go ahead and step back to down dog. I'm gonna stay facing you so you can see me, but you're just gonna pedal it out here. Just pedal it out, pressing your chest towards your thighs, relaxing through the neck and shoulders. Nice, now shift forward. Find a high plank for me, and then shift back. Find that down dog. Now we're gonna take an alternating reach back, okay? So I'm gonna reach my right hand toward my left calf shin ankle, and then shift forward, high plank. Other side. Hand to calf shin ankle, shift forward, high plank. Hand to calf shin ankle, and then shift forward. So it's an alternating reach back. As I reach back, I'm gazing underneath my armpit. Okay, you can move through this slow and steady. Just alternating reach back. So that should feel really good. Challenging your mobility here a little bit. But mobility is always good. Working on that range of motion, trying to improve. We're gonna take one more each side. Okay, tap it back. And shift forward, last one. Tap it back, shift forward, hold that high plank. You're gonna step your right foot outside your right hand and take a nice easy twist, windmilling the arm to the sky right here. Dropping my left hip towards the ground. That should feel so good. One of my favorite stretches right here. You want, you can give me a couple shoulder sweeps. Nice, a couple shoulder sweeps, other direction. It's gonna feel good for the shoulders, the chest, nice. Plant it down, step back, switch it out, other side. Left foot outside the left hand, dropping now my right hip towards the ground. Easy twist right here, holding here, dropping those hips towards the ground, feeling this in this outer glute and this hip flexor right here. Again, you can add those shoulder sweeps to the back. Nice, that feels good. Shoulder sweeps to the front. Nice. Lots of good mobility moves right here. Set it down, we're gonna do that one more time. Other side, same things. Right foot outside, right hand. I just love this stretch so much, and I think it's so good for our hips. Opening up tight hips, opening up tight glutes. Nice. Plant it down, step back, other side. Nice runner lunge, easy twist. Awesome job. Plant it down, step back, push back down, dog. Pedal out those heels again. This time you're gonna send the right toes long. You're gonna drop the right heel towards your butt. Take a nice hip opening stretch. You're gonna feel that in the quad too. That feels really good. Square your hips off to the mat. Step through, find a nice low lunge. Rise up, crescent lunge. Woo, sinking nice and low. Tuck this tailbone towards me. Opening up through this hip flexor. That feels really good, right? Reach back down, frame that front foot. Plant the hands here, and you're just gonna extend through that front foot, dropping your knee to your nose. Bend down. And extend, stretching through that front hamstring. Oh, this feels so good. Tap that back knee to the mat, and then extend. Everything melts long. Okay, we compress our muscles during strength training, during HIIT training. Compress the muscles. We gotta lengthen them out, right? Recovery is just as important as our workouts. One more right here. That feels really good. Nice, set it back down, step back, down dog. Other side, left toes go long. Drop that left heel towards the glute, opening up through the quad. That feels really good. Square the hips off to the mat. Step that left leg through. Find that low lunge. Rise up. Tuck that tailbone towards me. Keep that core nice and tight. Take the fingertips to the ground. Frame that front foot. Tap the back knee to the ground. Lengthen through the front leg. Knee to nose. Nice. Everything melts down through that front hamstring. Tap it down. Lengthen right here. Feels really good. Tap it down and lengthen. Just dropping. Let that neck and shoulder hang heavy. Two more, tap down, lengthen through that front hamstring. One more here, tap it down and lengthen. Nice, from here, step back, take one more down dog. From here, you're gonna drop your knees to the mat, and you're gonna take puppy dog stretch. So you're gonna walk your arms away from you, thumbs go up, hips stay high. So different than child's pose, my hips are high. Still sitting back into my hips, opening up through my lats right here. This feels so good. This is my favorite stretch, puppy dog stretch. I take it after every workout. And it's really good and really important for all those exercises where we push overhead. An overhead press, it gives us good range of motion and mobility, opening up through our lats right here. Opening up through those lats. Just hold it here for 3, 2, and 1. Walk it back in. You're gonna find tabletop. I'm gonna turn to the side. Finding that tabletop position, we're just gonna cat-cow. So find a nice neutral spine, shoulders stacked over wrist, hips over knees. And then you're gonna go into a cat. So I drop the belly, lift the chin, and then cow. Pull the spine up towards the ceiling as I tuck the chin towards my chest, looking down towards my knees or my quads. And nice, just do it again. Flowing through, keeping those shoulders down away from the ears. And push the spine up towards the ceiling, tuck the chin towards the chest. Nice, two more just like it. Inhale, cat. Exhale, cow. One more. Inhale, cat. Exhale, cow. Bring it back down, find that neutral spine. From here, big toes to touch. Open up the knees, take a nice wide base. You're gonna push back, child pose this time. So my hips sit back towards my heels. Fingertips walk away from me. From here, I can walk my fingertips over to the right side of the body, getting a nice little opening through this side body. Feels really good, opening the hips. Nice, big toes to touch and just sitting it back. Now walk my hands over to the left side of the body, reaching those fingertips as far away from me as I possibly can. Nice, bring it back to center, walk yourself up to a tabletop position, and from here, lower all the way down to your belly. Hands are gonna stay right here by my chest. Toes are on the ground, quads are gonna stay connected. Just push up for cobra. Push up, opening up through that front side of the body. Shoulders stay down and back, no need to overextend right here. Take a gentle gaze over one shoulder and a gentle gaze over the other shoulder. Should feel really good. From here, lower all the way back down. Bring the arms out to the side this time, finding a T. And we're gonna go to scorpion stretch. So I'm gonna take one toe and reach it back towards my opposite hand. This is gonna open up these hips, these quads, trying to keep both shoulders connected or close to the mat as possible, okay? Keep those palms connected. Nice. Get a nice shoulder stretch in there too. Bring it back to center, other side, roll over, trying to reach that toe back towards the hand. No need to touch, just getting a little gentle stretch through the shoulder, opening up through the quads and the hips. Should feel really good. Nice, bring it back to center. Replant those hands right here and push up and back to child's pose again. Pushing the hips back, opening up through the knees. Nice, bring it back to center. You're gonna go onto your bottom, finding a nice seated position. We're gonna finish with a couple arm stretches. So find a seated position that's comfortable for you. Relax the shoulders. We're just gonna start by taking the right arm across the body. Drop the shoulder, you can gaze over it if it feels good for you, and just roll out this wrist. Roll out the wrist. We forget about our wrists sometimes, how much work they do, all those planks, right? Nice. From here, you're gonna take the arm, you're gonna reach straight up and go for the back. Reach for the middle of the back, getting the tricep opening up right here. Feels really good. Awesome job. Go ahead, flap those arms out for me. Give me a quick shake. Nice. You're gonna do other arm. Left arm goes across the body. Drop the shoulder, roll out the wrist, right? Those wrist rolls, they feel so much better than you think they're going to. Roll out the wrist. Awesome job. From here, you're gonna take that left arm straight up overhead, bend at the elbow and give it a nice little gentle push towards the middle of your back, getting the triceps opening up through the lats. Awesome, from here, flap those wings a couple times. Take your right hand, plant it on the ground. Left arm goes up and over, big side body stretch. Other side, plant it down. Big side body stretch. Eagle arms for the finish. Take my right arm, wrap it under and around my left arm, palms to touch. I'm gonna reach my fingertips up towards the sky, elbows come towards you, open up through the back. Oh, that feels so good. So good, nice. Gently unwind, we'll go other side. This time take your left arm, right arm goes under, thread the needle, get those palms to touch, fingertips towards the sky, elbows towards you. And shake it out. Awesome job, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this stretch routine. A great way to cool down after any workout. Come back, do it again, especially 24 hours after a tough workout. You're really gonna like it. I hope you come back. More of my workouts are linked here on this page. I look forward to sweating with you guys soon.